The Nile River gets its name from the Greek word nelios, meaning river valley. This river is 6,700 kilometers long and flows through 9 countries. That's great if you're a fish and don't get caught. For us as non-swimmers, our Nile River excursion was on a 5-star luxury cruiser that took us close up through 5,000 years of ancient Egyptian history. And as our cruise boat glided smoothly by the palm tree dotted riverbanks, we viewed timeless farming scenes and drifting sand dunes. On the way, we also visited many historic sites such as the Valley of the Kings and Queens. But first, a few moments to tell you how we got to this area. We started by flying into Cairo, then spent a few days at Alexandria, then Giza, where the main pyramids are. You can catch up on what we did there on another video. Most visitors to southern Egypt take the overnight train. In our case, with comfort controls and budget set to maximum, we took the 1 hour, 700 kilometer flight from Cairo to Aswan, then a half hour, 300 kilometer flight to Abu Simbel. After visiting Abu Simbel, we flew back to Aswan, visited Philae, then boarded our luxury cruiser. This is all comfortably done in one day. And now, some of the highlights of the historic places we visited. First, Abu Simbel. Abu Simbel is an archaeological site comprising two massive rock temples in southern Egypt on the western bank of Lake Nasser, about 290 kilometers southwest of Aswan. It is part of the UNESCO World Heritage Site known as the Nubian Monuments, which run from Abu Simbel downriver to Philae near Aswan. The twin temples were originally carved out of the mountainside during the reign of Pharaoh Ramses II in the 13th century BC as a lasting monument to himself and his queen Nefertari to commemorate his alleged victory at the Battle of Kadesh and to intimidate his Nubian neighbours. However, the complex was relocated in its entirety in the 1960s on an artificial hill made from a domed structure high above the Aswan Dam Reservoir. The relocation of the temples was necessary to avoid their being submerged during the creation of Lake Nasser, the massive artificial water reservoir formed after the building of the Aswan Dam on the Nile River. Abu Simbel remains one of Egypt's top tourist attractions. The history behind these amazing monuments make fascinating reading. After a short break, we boarded our plane and headed back to Aswan. Construction of the Aswan High Dam started in 1960, and I recall it was an engineering wonder at the time. We had a good look around the dam for about 10 minutes and then left. The next morning, after a night of unaccustomed luxury on the cruise boat, we continued with our Nile River excursions. After breakfast, our personal minivan took us to Philae Quay, a few kilometres south of the Aswan High Dam, where we headed out to the Philae Temple on Aglika Island. The original Philae Island is now underwater, and, like the monuments of Abu Simbel, the Philae Temple was moved to higher ground to accommodate the dam. Moving these massive monuments themselves in the 60s was an engineering feat that rivaled their original construction, which was over 2,000 years ago. Aglika Island was even reshaped to imitate the original island of Philae as closely as possible. The ancient Egyptians built this magnificent temple for the goddess Isis. Isis was an ideal mother, wife, and patron of nature and magic. A bit like Lillian, really. Worship of this god dates back 4,500 years. There is literally tons of stuff to read here, but now, thanks to the internet, you can directly translate all these historical writings and read them for yourself in English. We ended our visit to Philae by looking at the usual touristy bits. We then decided that we would like to take a cruise down a river on a felucca. A felucca is a traditional wooden sailing boat whose rig consists of two lateen sails. If you're a budget traveller, you can take a Nile River cruise on one of these, but of course, it doesn't have toilets or rooms and you have to sleep under the stars. But because it's wind powered, it's a popular method of tourist transport because of its calm and quiet ride. On a what?
On a felucca. What a fluke.
What a fluke. What a felucca. After the felucca ride, we switched to a motorboat and then headed out to a model Nubian village. No safety rails. Standing in the waters of the Nile River, I've always wanted to do this.
He's been riding the camel, and me, it's my camel. Stephen, turn around!
Camel ride. Holy! Dangerous. At the village, we were introduced to a Nubian family, their pet crocodile, their camel, their goat, their spices, their smoking pipes, their travels to Mecca, and a drink which we politely declined, and notably their toilet, where you use your left hand and water instead of toilet paper. It was here also that Lillian got a henna tattoo. After visiting their school, where we got lessons in the Arabic numerals and the alphabet, it was back to our cruise boat, where we set sail to Kom Ombo. Fifty kilometres later, we arrived at Kom Ombo to continue our daily diet of Egyptian culture and history. It's a popular place for cruise boats, and up to 25 boats can be stacked up against each other all at once. What I enjoyed most about this place was pronouncing its name, which to me looked like it should have been pronounced Ombo Combo Bombo. Try saying that, it's fun. The temple at Kom Ombo is unique because it's dedicated to two gods, Sobek, the crocodile god, and Horus, the falcon-headed god. The layout combines two temples in one, with each side having its own gateways and chapels. As usual, there was heaps to read here. Many captive and mummified crocodiles were kept here. The next morning, we found ourselves at Edfu. Rolling on a river. town of Edfu was built around 2,200 years ago, and today is an important centre for sugar production and pottery making. A short 20-minute ride from our cruise boat took us to the Temple of Horus, where we were dosed with another day of ancient Egyptian history. The temple itself, unlike the modern town, contains more than 3,000 years of history. The heavily carved twin towers at the entrance are 36 meters high and contain scenes of the king smiting his enemies before his god Horus. Two statues of the Horus falcon stand in front of the main gateway. Horus is the son of Isis and Osiris. He's god of the sky, hence became depicted as a falcon. Every rock tells a story, and these ones are no exception. What a fascinating journey it was as we made our way into the inner sanctuary, the Holy of Holies, where there is a replica of the Bark of Horus. Still reeling from the information being fed to us by our personal tour guide, we headed back to the cruise boat to relax and then cruise on up to Esther. Esther has a small market with hassle-free shopping. Yeah, right. The Temple of Kanam, the god of reproductive conception, is still under excavation. At this bakery, people are fighting to buy bread, a reflection of the poverty and lack of resources here. A Nile River cruise has often been considered one of life's must-do experiences. Luxury cruising on a five-star ship is one way of doing this and offers an intensely exotic take on a holiday. Having cruised on other rivers such as the Lei River in China, the Rhine River in Germany, this cruise, without a shadow of a doubt, ticked all the boxes when it came to indulgence. With less than 100 passengers on board and just as many crew, we enjoyed exclusive service, luxurious accommodation, mouth-watering cuisine, and a variety of recreational and entertainment options. What an unforgettable experience, voyaging the route of pharaohs, in style. I've always wondered what it was like to sail down the Nile River in a five-star luxury cruiser. but I don't need to wonder anymore. The original plan was to sail from Esna to Luxor, but due to problems in traversing the River Lock, we had to leave the ship early and drive there instead. On the way, we visited the Valley of the Kings, the Valley of the Queens, and the Colossi of Memnon. The Valley of the Kings is located across the river from the ancient city of Thebes, which today is the modern city of Luxor. There are no less than 62 tombs and chambers here. You cannot take pictures inside the tombs, so the only way to find out what it looks like inside is to go there. The Valley of the Queens is only minutes from the Valley of the Kings. There are over 70 tombs here of queens, princesses, and princes. Again, no photos allowed, and you have to go there in person to view the burial chambers. There's that guy Horace again. As usual, our tour guide filled us in on all the detail. By the way, our tour of Egypt only had Lillian and I on it, so we got to know what life is like in Egypt today, not just what it was like 3,000 to 4,000 years ago. Shortly before arriving at Luxor, we stopped at the Colossi of Memnon for a photo shoot. These statues are 3,400 years old. At Luxor, we decided we wouldn't go into the smaller temple, but instead headed for the larger one just up the road. Luxor is a busy place with a population of 380,000, and tourists are well catered for here. The history of this temple started in 1400 BCE, with its construction being kicked off by King Ramses II. Imagine standing here for 3,400 years. These stones would have a lot to tell. Destination in southern Egypt was at the Maritime Island Resort. Located on King's Island, this resort is set in beautiful subtropical gardens and boasts views of some of the best sunsets on the Nile. The unique resort is nestled amid spacious landscape gardens on a 630,000 square meter privately owned island in the River Nile itself. This award-winning hotel offered excellent cuisine and a relaxing location with Luxor's only infinity pool. A bonus is that shorts and jandals attire are allowed in the dining room. A huge range of activities are available here. Dining, although we had our own food, fishing, sailing, board games, table tennis, even a private zoo. The camel here was just lovely. Her name was Cleopatra. The next morning, we flew back to Cairo for a second visit, this time to catch up on more Egyptian history at the Egyptian Museum. But that's a story for another day.